MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game one of the American League Division Series between the Tampa Bay Rays and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Garrett Cole will do the pitching in front of the hometown crowd here in game one. Dan, any thoughts?
Not many better in the game than this guy right here, Matt. Garrett Cole, he brings the goods. Fastball approaches near 100 miles an hour, hard assortment of breaking pitches, and on top of that, he's a winner and he loves to be a big game pitcher. You'll know early if he's attacking the strike zone and has a 1-2-3 inning. Pretty good chance he's not giving up very many runs in this one.
Lifted the other way to left center. Left fielder is on the move. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down.
Batting second. The second baseman, Brandon Lau.
So next to bat will be Brandon Lau. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Here's Randy Arozarena. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two. Lau, base runner at first with one out. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around at strike three. Striding in is G-Man Choi. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
So now here is Manuel Margot looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. Here's the 1-1. And a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. One and two. Here it is. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. We're back with more of game one after this message and a word from our local stations. Ryan Yarbrough gets the call in hostile territory here for game one of the division series. What's your take on him?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first.
The right fielder. Aaron Judge.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
That is good.
And with two away now, let's give you a look at the big picture here. There you see the participants in this year's playoffs. Next to hit, Aaron Hicks, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Still no score. Left center. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there and makes the play for the first down. Now at the plate here is Willie Adames. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. In the air down the line and left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. Now at the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. No score here as we play inning number two. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there.
Well, we all know he can burn on a base pass, right? But that's a little tougher to do when you've got a nice goose egg on your leg. It's tough to do like that.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than the pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
Sharp ground ball to third. Throw on to Boyd, takes care of him, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Rays. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. Lifetime versus this arm. He's hitting 429. He's taken him deep once. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
A bouncer up the middle. He's got it. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
That is good. the first baseman.
Next for New York, Luke Voit. And that one yanked just foul. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
That is good.
So the bases are empty here with two gone. And that will bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Bottom of the second here with no score. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. We'll move to the third with no score. So here's Mike Zunino. His career line against Gerrit Cole. He's totaled four hits in 21 at-bats. He also has one home run. One. Hit sharply on the ground, and the Rays are in the hit column.
And that's hitting 101 right there, guys. The only way you're able to execute that type of base hit on that type of pitch is to recognize it early, stay tall, stay back, and trust the process.
In now, Austin Meadows swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Zunino on at first, nobody out. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Rays DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home. Battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat. Digging in will be Brendan Lau. Worked a walk his first time up. The 2-1.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like. And drive it right now.
And this is down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that runner in first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
Is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. That's back-to-back strikeouts now, as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single in the scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control of this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
Stepping in now, Randy Arozarena. In there, 1-2 now.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down the way, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Here now, the 2-2. It's laid off, and the count runs full.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Popped him up. LeMahieu range shallow right. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Bottom of the inning now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Clint Frazier. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Into the windup and the pitch. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Gio Urshela. Still on the lookout for hit number one here. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and they're down.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And hey, a strikeout always works too.
Into the box, Gary Sanchez.
Nope.
2-1 for his career in this matchup. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. Try to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Two-two. Inning number three, nothing our score. And another foul ball. Working for the punch out and the offering.
Right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Now the payoff pitch home, and he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu. Comes the 1-2. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Swing and a shot toward right center. It's down for extra bases, and the Yankees have their first hit of the game. Frazier blows through the stop sign, headed for home. The tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. Into the box now, Aaron Judge. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You look for situations like this.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Now the payoff pitch home. Swung on and missed, strike three. Yanks strand a pair. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. New inning set to get underway, and that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi.
The old adage, pitching and defense, are so far, they've certainly kept both offenses in check.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Fouled off.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4-6 right here.
And the knuckle curve that time. Got him swinging, and that's the first out. One out here in the Tampa Bay fourth. And that'll bring up the versatile center fielder, Manuel Margot. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. It's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Full count, 3-2.
There's ball four.
Take the base.
Wow, you know he's not happy with that call. When it crossed the plate, it sure looked like a strike to me. Seemed to catch a ton of the plate. That's a tough way to give up a walk, but he's got to put it behind him now.
To the plate now, Joey Wendell. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
To 2-2 now. As a look, now the pitch. Drilled on the ground is short. That's through for a base hit, and he's 1-2 now.
Nice adjustment by the batter right there. You cannot fault the pitcher for going to that well again. First one, he swings and misses through, and this one, the batter's able to execute and drive it for a base hit.
At the plate now, Willy Adames. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. He'll go to second for one, and it's by him into right field.
Hey!
Well, definitely should have been a two ball there, but you got to get one first. Got under the feed to second and just sailed it. Could be a costly mistake.
In now, Kevin Kiermaier. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this is just going to be a foul ball.
With one out and runners on the corner, some managers like to hit and run here. It's a little risky, but it can help you stay out of the double play if it's well executed.
Here comes the 1-2. It's laid off for ball two.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
A full count to the Rays center fielder.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
On the fourth, an inning-ending double play. That's how you roll it. 5-4-3, a double play sends us to break. Back with more from game one after this. ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Aaron Hicks. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Hit hard on the ground to second. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
The bat.
Giancarlo Stanton now.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Cut fastball, and there's strike two. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now. Giancarlo swings, and this ball is hit well into left field. A leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. It's a solo blast off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. And the Yankees have drawn even now at one apiece.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
At the plate, Luke Voit just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
Hold him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Fouled away. Now the payoff pitch home. Again, he sends it out of play. 3-2, one more time. He loses him on ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Now into the box, Clint Frazier worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Good eye as he lays off, and the count moves to 2-1 now on the Yankee left fielder.
That's where he wants that sinker to end up, but that's a nice job of laying off.
All even now, 2-2. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. Hit hard back up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
In now, Gio Urshela. They're two balls and two strikes now. Now a southpaw up to throw in that Tampa Bay bullpen. Here's the 2-2. Now a ground ball and a chance for Adames at short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. But the Yankees are able to tie things up on the solo home run. We played four, all even now at 1-1. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. The 2-1 home.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself off ace. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind you.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
And it's fouled away.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Judge. He's got it one away. So it's back to the top of the order now. And Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. One run, two hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Popped him up. And there's out number two. So next to hit is Brandon Lau, who went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7, 8 pitch ABs. Sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here. Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. Halfway home, all even at one apiece. Welcome back to Miami as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Cody Reed, the 6'5" left-hander, takes over now.
Number 21, Cody Reed.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. The 1-1 home. Grounder down the line at third. Fielded cleanly. And that's out number one.
Now that
into the box. DJ LeMahieu in his career against this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0 for 1. The 1-1. Slapped hard the opposite way. Into the slide, and he comes up with a great catch for the second out.
Well, this one was squared up pretty good, but just like pitchers give up hits, executed pitches, batters make outs on balls they couldn't have hit much better.
Into the box, Aaron Judge. To 1-2 now. One run on three hits. One error on the Yankee line score so far. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone. The classic back foot there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And a fastball misses there. Ball four.
Now batting, center fielder.
Runner at first with two gone in the inning. And that'll bring up the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. The 2-2. Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. One left for the Yankees. We played five full, tied at one aside. So stepping in is Randy Arozarena. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Double-barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose.
That's a
falling behind now. 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
He somehow gets that one by him. 3-2 now. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter's aboard to start the sixth.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner, and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, G-Man Choi. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. High in the air out towards shallow right. Judge has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first out. Here comes the Yankee manager now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And it appears that we've seen the last here in this one of Gerrit Cole. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first. And the best he can do is a no decision in this one. Albert Abreu enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Manuel Margot will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. There's a called strike on the curveball.
One ball, one and two.
Two
strikes.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against the modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. High and deep to right center. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out. Next up is Joey Wendell, singled last time up. And that misses, two and one.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
The 2-1 home. A Rosarena, runner at first with two gone. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Rays strand just the one. Score remains tied 1-1. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and striding forward the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. And he misses, 2-1. And action now in the Tampa Bay pen as it looks like a right-hander's begun to get loose. Now the 2-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
2-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Into the box now, Luke Voigt. Hit back up the middle. And there's out number two. Two away now in the Yankees sixth. And that will bring up Gleyber Torres. Yankee shortstop behind in the count one and two. And he popped him up. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. Left center, base hit.
Now that the left fielder. Great.
Standing in now, Clint Frazier. A little bit outside. 2-1.
Well, that's a breaking ball right there. Backdoor slider. Just missed the corner. As they say, that's a Hall of Fame pitch.
I tried to jerk that one, and it's 2-2. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Perfect.
Well, he's really been good all game long until that one. He was definitely not trying to hit a guy when he's got two strikes on him. It just appeared that it got away from him.
And now here is Gio Urshela. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. grounded to short. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Yanks strand a pair. Still tied one apiece. And now, Willy Adames. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. The 1-1. Misses, ball 2.
Games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And the count will be full. Hard hit ball to second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Stepping in once again is Kevin Kiermaier. He was a double play victim last time around.
He doesn't have to worry about that in this situation, Matty. No one on base right now. Try and get something up so you can drive the baseball.
And it's a ball and 2 strikes to Kiermaier now.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that getting the over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
Breaks his bat as this one's popped up. Abreu over to his right, 2 down. Here now is Mike Zunino. A hit and 2 at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Rays. Score remains deadlocked at 1. Last half of the 7th here, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. There's a drive to deep left center. You can pretty much forget about this one. This is way out of here. Solo shot here for Gary Sanchez, and the Yankees take the lead. It's 2-1.
Yeah, and you never want to downplay a home run, but they've had runners on base all game long and couldn't get a home run in that situation. Hey, it's only a solo shot, but they'll take it. But you have to think they're feeling like they missed some opportunities in this one.
Colin McHugh comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7. In now, DJ LeMahieu. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left the yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
And he misses ball 4. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Man, when you don't get a call on a pitch that good, you have to wonder if maybe it's personal. You can't blame him for being angry, but he's got to find a way to move on and focus on the next batter.
So here is Aaron Judge, leadoff man on, and we'll see what they have in mind strategy-wise here. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Whoa, that pitch is out.
Two and two the count. LeMahieu aboard here at first with nobody out. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an oar. The strikeout, one gone.
Now batting.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. 1-1, here it is. And this one's in the dirt. And boy, he didn't quite know what to do on that one, but he's lucky to barely get back at first. Now the 2-1 pitch. Waves for strike number two. Runners on first with one down. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Up next to the Yankees, the first baseman.
And stepping in, Luke Voit. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Looking to keep this a one-run game.
Whoa,
the pitch. Fastball. And looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
3-1 here. You have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
He set the 3-2. Swung out and fouled as it looked to make it all the way up into the concourse area. Able to add on one more via the solo home run. 7 complete here tonight. 2-1 New York. Zach Britton has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 53. Zach.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Austin Meadows. In previous meetings with Britton over the years, he's a 333 hitter. Now the 1-1 pitch is a slider taken for a ball. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Here comes the 2-1. 2-2.
2-2.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Looking up is Hicks. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Solo shot to right center, and just like that, this ball game is all tied.
Big time at bat right there. Team trailing, and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
Oh. So now to the plate, Brandon Lau.
Two balls.
Well, too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Bases are empty here, nobody out. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Of course, there was a fastball.
Three and two now. Randy Arozarena is on deck. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
You know he's probably still thinking about that game-tying home run he just gave up, but I'm going to give him credit for not showing that it's bothering him. When you come back and strike out the next guy, it shows you've still got your head in the right place.
Blake now, Randy Arozarena.
Ball three.
And he misses again, ball three.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
The 3-1. And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
G-Man Choi the next to hit. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there and he's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung at it.
At the plate, Manuel Margot. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. And a 2-2 sinker falls in there. 3-2 now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is under it. And that's the third out. But a run scores in the inning, and that'll have to be good enough as this solo home run knots things up. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Chaz Rome is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 50, Chaz Rome.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. The 2-2 pitch. Liner toward right center. There's a base hit, so just like that, the leadoff man's aboard representing the potential go-ahead run.
Just an unbelievable piece of hitting right there. Staying on the inner half of that baseball right there. Staying to it and through it, not coming around it, and able to drive it the other way.
Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. for the delivery. A check on that go-ahead run at first. Strike, and he's behind one and two now. Now we'll see some action in the bullpen as the lefty starts to get loose. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's one.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Standing in now, Gio Urshela down the first baseline. And he dives, but he can't make the play. It lands foul. That's a deal on a ball and two strikes. Here's a little chopper to the right side. And indeed, he won't try to force it at second. He'll just flip on to first for the sure out. Tyler Wade will try and loosen up here as he'll be second base following the injury. Next to dig in, Gary Sanchez. It was a solo shot for him in his last at-bat. Catcher.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late, and you can't even put a good swing on it.
Ready with the 1-2. Swing and a miss as the slider sets him down for the final out of the inning. Big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. We're back with more of game one after this message and a word from our local stations. Tyler Wade will stay in the ball game as a new shortstop.
A defensive team for the Yankees. Now playing shortstop.
Justin Wilson will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ball game tied until the bottom half.
Number 34, Justin Wilson.
Set to start the ninth in this one, and set to go is the third baseman, Joey Wendell. Here comes the 1-2. misses with it, ball four, so the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
Now back, the center fielder.
Michael Brusso will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Now running at first base for the win. Number 33.
Now to bat, Kevin Kiermaier. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 1-1 pitch. Out in the Yankee bullpen now as a right-hander starts to loosen up. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule.
Next
to stand in is Mike Zunino. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Pitch. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
Wendell on second. Brisson at first, one gone. A swing and a miss, and that, folks, is a big out number two.
This is, I think, really a lot from him in this hit. The cutter darting in on the hitters in the opposite batter's box, it can be a real effective pitch when it's located well, and that one was right there.
Austin Meadows will stand in yet again, and he, of course, has had one of the big blows in the contest so far. This was back in the eighth, as this solo shot proved to be a very important run in this ballgame. Two and one, here it is.
Nope, that's the ball.
Well, two on, two outs, and he's got himself in a great hitter's count. Just has to be careful not to get too aggressive. A walk would be good here, too.
A 3-1 pitch. It's up to a 3-2 full count now. Rip down the line. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. A payoff pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The payoff pitch. Another one sent foul. Making it work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fouled off. Ready with another two-strike offering. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Ready with the payoff pitch. High in the air out to center field. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. Back with more from Game 1 after this. Michael Brusso will stay in the ballgame as a new
game for the Rays. Now playing shortstop. Number
33. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And set to go is the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. The 1-1.
Shocked he didn't pick up the rosin bag and see if he could get a foul ball on that one. He had to if he would swing way outside the zone.
tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. Aaron Judge will be next. Count is full. Here's the pitch. Hit to short. He's got it. And there's one away. Now it'll be Aaron Judge. Lifetime against this pitcher. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. He's also gone down on strike times. And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge. Still 1-2. Misses out of the zone. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been sent a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box now, Aaron Hicks. Two balls and two strikes to Hicks now. A little bouncer. And a strikeout here yet again. Been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Darren O'Day takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings.
Number 56. Darren.
Brendan Lau, who could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Grounded to third. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
I know he didn't smoke that one from the offensive standpoint, but you know what? A knock's a knock, especially to lead off an inning. Game tied, and it's getting late. That could prove to be pivotal.
So now to the plate, Randy Arozarena. And it misses. 3-1 now. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
Huge innings have begun with much less, I can tell you that. First and second, no out, and the guy on the bump really needs a strikeout or a double play right here.
So here's the cleanup hitter, G-Man Choi.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Now 3-2 pitch. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. With another two strike offering. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you have to come inside the strike zone. You could just stand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Stepping in now, Manuel Margot. Hit down the third baseline. This will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Frazier is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Big spot here. First and second. Two men gone. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell. Sinker misses that time and it's 2-1.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and making some good pitches.
Lau, second, Rosarena at first, two out in the inning. Two balls and two strikes now.
On the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Toward right center field. Hicks gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Rays strand a pair. Score remains 2-2. Ryan Thompson comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here, and digging in is the veteran DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Here comes the 1-2. Stanton is down on strikes for round number one.
Ready to go.
So now into the box is Boynton. He bounced out last time up. Grounded back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time at first. And that'll bring up Tyler Wade. The set and the 2-1. Chop weak left. Two out, nobody on. Fly ball off to the left side. And that's in there. Base hit. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there. Two out base knock to put the winning run on base. Let's see if someone can catch a gap in that.
Plate now, Clint Frazier fouled away. Ready with another two strike offering. Softly hit toward the hole. Well, on to first, and we are going to the 11th inning. Yanks lead one, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Jonathan Loaisiga takes the mound to start the 11th inning.
Now pitching for the New York Yankees, number 43, Jonathan Loaisiga.
Mike Brosseau digging in at the plate. He has no prior history against this pitcher. Here comes the 1-2. This one up. LeMahieu is there. One down. Stepping up is Kevin Kiermaier. Pitch is swung on and popped up, and this will also head toward the right side of the infield. Ready now is Mike Zunino. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
And it's fouled away.
He's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Sanchez has it. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Set now for the bottom of the 11th, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela. The 1-1 home is in off the plate. Good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
You never want to take the aggression away from a ball player, but in this situation, I'd like to see the leadoff guy try and work the count a little bit more, especially when this pitcher's missing like he is.
And slider. Oh, got a favorable call on that one, as that's the first out of the inning.
Wow, we've seen some really impressive pitching this one. You could say these lineups have been anemic, but I always like to give credit to pitching and defense, and they've been fantastic all game long.
In now, Gary Sanchez. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
And bouncing ball, foul. 2-2 pitch. Hit hard to short. And this is through in the left, and there's your possible winning run aboard on the leadoff single.
A nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. I know there's one out in the inning. They got one more to play with that they could potentially be productive with. But this guy's looking to end this right now and put something in a gap.
For that and missed. Here's the throw. Not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. With another two-strike offering, and he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Lau is under it, two gone. Ryan Sheriff, the 6'1" southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here. Here's Big Aaron Judge. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
The 3-1 pitch. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. So that's the second walk he's worked in this one.
Yeah, that seems to be a popular approach when this guy steps in. He can really hurt you with one swing. So I think the idea is mostly not to let this one guy beat you, Matt.
Into the box now, Aaron Hicks. Bouncer up the middle. Scooped up, throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Yanks strand a pair. Score remains 2-2. On to the 12th frame in this one, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. Strike two, swinging.
I try to tell people all the time, you're facing 90 to 92, 94. You can still see seams. It starts getting above 94. It starts to blur itself a little bit. You start pitching where this guy's at, you're seeing nothing. You're seeing vapor.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Brandon Lau. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Hey, it's much easier to lay up the breaking stuff when it's coming in towards you instead of when it breaks away. A good take there.
And he fouls this one off. The 2-2.
Bullpen, 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at-bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
So the next to bat will be Randy Arozarena. He's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. The 1-1 pitch. first ball by him here. 1-2 now.
His heater's got some late ride through the zone. A lot of late swings right now. You're only going to get to that pitch if you get the front foot down early.
Now just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike. And that's the second out of the inning. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take. And he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
Stepping in now, G-Man Choi. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The payoff pitch. And he misses with it. Ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0 for 4, but this is a great opportunity to make a man.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Strand a pair, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Bottom of the 12th inning now, and standing in is the DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Give in, and the at-bat will continue. Hard second misses the 2-2. Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH. Pitch on its way. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Margot's going back. On the warning track, he makes the catch. At the plate is
Luke Boyd,
attempting to, as they say, get off the schneid here. 0 for 5 so far. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first. Digging in next, Tyler Wade. Game on the line here, and a ball deep in the gap would make this place explode. The 1-1 pitch.
looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Possible winning run on first, one man away. And that misses ball four. So now the potential winning run moves into scoring position where a single could end this thing.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that with too much.
At the plate now, Clint Frazier. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Easy there, big fella. Two and two. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Two gone. Nick Anderson trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away.
Now pitching for the Rays, number 70, Nick Anderson.
Gio Urshela will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. The 1-1 pitch. Well, this is lined into left center, and it's going to get down out there.
Bort
is digging for home, and they will walk off with game one here at home.
Man, the postseason always seems to deliver big moments, and this was no exception. A walk-off in the final at-bat ends it, and there's bedlam at home plate. Wow!